Here we are, Q&A session 21, and we're in a different location. We're down by the creek at Zaytuna Farm. It's a lovely sight. So, first question, and it comes from Lloyd. I recently watched a YouTube video from Richard Perkins, who does some great work, of Ridgedale permaculture in Sweden. He does not use swales on the property, but instead uses keyline design techniques to even out water distribution. I'll be developing a food forest at 42 degrees latitude, 2 hours north of New York City. The closest location for rainfall data is an average of 46.5 inches per year, 1,182 millimeters. Rainfall has been about 30% less over the last 3 years. Is there a point to where annual rainfall is sufficient to not use swales? Or is there a risk of focusing on annual rainfall average? Higher organic matter levels should increase water holding capacity, correct? Yeah, that's correct. Is there evidence from science trials that keyline methods can meet Yeoman's claims? Well, yeah, I mean, Yeoman's is a great system. It's a wonderful system. We use it all the time. It's wonderful. It's a de-compaction system over landscape before you forest, if you're going to forest broad areas, or in grazing regimes. So you, every time you think it's a little bit compacted or you need to rejuvenate the soil, you run through and you PA Yeoman's, have the Yeoman's plow and go through and deep rip and relieve the compaction. And today you can seed with a seed box on there, and you can also drip compost tea in there as well. And it's all great stuff. Swales are slightly different because they're permanent features of earthworks and they harvest water en masse to tree lines. So swales are tree grown systems themselves. They're not grazing systems, where Yeoman's can be a grazing system, or once implemented can then be treed, but that's the last time you're going to get through because you can't get through with the trees. Yeoman's also goes right across the broad landscape, where swales come through on contour and they produce permanent tree lines, and those trees go down and put deep roots into the soil, and they bring up minerals from deep down and interact with fungi. And that fungi then interacts with the interswale, which can be crops or it can be pasture with keyline applied in between the swales in the interswale. But also harvest water, like this water. And that then enhances ponds and aquaculture. It actually creates spring lines. So swales are more likely to accumulate bulk water and make it easier to apply aquaculture. Now, aquaculture is the next chapter in the course, and we're going to talk about how aquaponic type effects happen with nutrient flows and how water can be used to clean up quite organically soiled water and turn it into nutrient flow in solution, how it can be productive in itself, how it can be central to our system. So if you don't have swales, you are depriving yourself a little bit of the ability to harvest that little bit more water, have that little bit more incredibly productive aquaculture. That's your choice. If you want to do that, that's fine. I love aquaculture systems. I love having fish in a property. I love having those nutrients in solution. But you can do it without swales if you want. If you want to not have swales and just have Yeoman's, Yeoman's works fine, and it will work with swales too. They both work. They're fantastic systems. They're different in how they apply. You can graze over Yeoman's decompaction. You can't graze over swales, but you grow trees continuously on swales and you harvest more water that backfloods to charge dams, and you soak nutrient in solution through swales, where Yeoman's is an absorption system over the broader area.